Hello to all of our BPTV fans, YouTube fans, and new fans. We appreciate all of you. Thank you for watching. Thanks for your great feedback. We're ready to do our ninth. I can't believe this is my ninth painting show with Maria's Ideas Teaches Us to Paint. My co-producer, co-host has a theme today. Wait till you hear this. I'm excited. What is the theme, Maria?
Thank you, Alan. So we are here on the hilltop in the Southside Slopes, and at Jono's, our studio, Maria's Ideas, and we are going to draw this freehand. Actually, you don't even have to draw too much. We just cut a little marks on the canvas. It'll be easy. So he's a little nervous.
I am nervous.
But trust
today.
Me, follow the pickle and listen to what I say, Alan, and you'll be good, okay?
Yes, ma'am. I salute you.
All right.
You've helped me to progress this year.
Yeah.
Where I'm starting to feel comfortable until today.
No, you'll be fine. You'll
this
be good.
Is our first vertical painting,
easy.
Too.
Yes.
I'm honored to carry on.
Yes. So this one I designed for this time of year. It's called Nature Walk.
Wow.
This time of year, I like to get out. It's really good to get out and take a walk in the woods and enjoy nature. It's good for the soul.
And September 1st, we have fall-like weather.
It feels so good. So what we're going to do, we're not doing our typical drawing and transferring. We also have all the little videos on Maria's Ideas Art on the YouTube channel, which for each design, but this one is only a couple minutes. So this is a watercolor pencil. You can use a graphite pencil, you can use chalk. If you use a watercolor pencil, it will, when it gets wet and activated with the paint, it'll just blend right back in. So we
this
don't
is
see
so
pencil
cool.
lines.
No, so, I'm not
yeah.
so nervous
no,
now.
No, we're good. So what we're going
I
to do.
I can draw whatever I want.
No.
Where's the pickle?
All right, so here's what we're going to do. We're going to look at the canvas on the left side. You don't need to measure. You don't need a tape measure or anything
just
like that.
Just use my eye.
Just figure kind of maybe 6 inches up and put a little line right there on the left side. But 6 inches up and just draw across like that. Real light. Keep it light so that it blends. All right. Now let's take about 2/3 over. We're going to make a little mark like this. Just a little mark. This is just to indicate where we're going to, this is our vanishing point.
Okay.
Okay. So now this will be the hill. So let's come down a little bit like to this. Just come down a little bit and stop where that line is. Start at the top and bring it down. Okay. That's good. And now on this side, we want to come up, but not as far as this, because we want this the hillside on the right side to be a little lower. So we're just going to do that.
Whoa.
Okay, so this is
I'll try my artistic
that's a little
teacher.
Hill. Just go up. Yep, just keep it a little lower. Perfect. Now from this point again, bring this line, put a little mark about maybe 3 inches.
3 inches.
From the left corner. And take this mark right here.
Yeah.
Not, but you know, down here where they meet, and just bring that down like that. Bring it over
bring
to that point. Mm-hmm. Bring it over to that point where you. So you always want to look where you're going, not where you came from. When you're drawing from one point to another, it makes it easier.
I think I got it.
You know what I mean? If you're looking here, it's harder to get to that point. If you look where you're going, same thing when we do certain brush strokes. And then this one, we'll just kind of do like that, something like that.
Oh, I gotta try to
so what this is, we want our pathway in the foreground to be wider because that's, yes, perfect. So there you have your hills and your pathway, and the rest is just paint. You're done drawing. You did good.
This is unbelievable.
You're done. Mic drop. All right, let's go. So we are going to, so where the colors today, we are using white, a medium blue, yellow, red, orange, and black. So we try to keep it at 6 colors, keep it simple for the art kits and just for people buying.
Keep it simple, yes.
Yeah, and people buying supplies. So I don't think we have a visual for this brush. We're using a different brush. This is a 1-inch flat shader.
First ever.
Yeah. So we usually use the smaller one. So we're going to use this one, and we are going to paint this entire background. We're using acrylics. They dry quickly, and you typically paint from the background to the foreground. So that tree will be the last thing.
I have listened, so I understand that.
Yes, you did know that when I asked you. So the tree and the people will go on last, okay? So let's paint the background. So we want to try to keep this wet, the whole canvas, as we're working. Keep that wet edge. Keep it moving. But you want to start in the center with the white, but we don't want a true white. We want a little bit of a dirty white. I usually say, oh, I need my little plate here. So we're going to put a tiny bit of blue in there. We want this to look a little foggy back here. So we're taking a generous amount of white.
Okay. I'll try to do
that. And we'll put that on your palette. And then just stick the corner of the brush into a little bit of this blue. This blue is really strong. Put that to the side of the paint and then incorporate it into the white. You see I'm flipping the brush? Don't smush the brush. Flip it. See like this. Watch. Flip. If you flip it, it mixes and it loads the brush at the same time. Now, acrylics dry slightly darker. So I like this color. This is the color I like, but it's going to dry a little darker, which means I should add a little bit more of white because I don't want that color once it dries. So you can see we have a white, but it's not a true white. Okay? I think you need a little bit more white, Alan. Okay. And since there's so much blue there, just start off to the side. You have a lot of... Just do it right there.
Okay.
Because you just mix it there because you have...
Oh, okay.
No, don't take that. You already have enough blue on your brush.
I see
you
what you're saying.
You just want to add...
Yeah, wait, let me do that
again. You need to get some of that. Take some off on your paper towel.
Let me try to get that, and then I'll try to clean
up. Yeah, you have too much blue on there. Just, wipe the extra off on your paper towel.
All right.
Yeah, and just use white and start in another section. So if there's too much of one color...
Is this better here, or should it a little more
white? Still whiter, because it's going to dry a little darker. More white.
Okay.
That's probably good. Maybe a little bit more white. So you really want
this
to be very
light.
Whoa, that
is really pale.
Yes, because this is the center. So what we're doing
is
we're...
And I'm trying to flip the brush too. So.
Yes, very good. Because you don't want the bristles to get all bent and out of shape. So we're starting right here, which is this lightest, brightest. That's our light source.
So we're down to where...
We're right here in this...
Oh, we're into where we made it a little lower.
So we are painting. We're starting with the light color, and we're coming up, and then we're going to introduce more of the blue. But we still don't want it to be as dark as the blue in our tray. We want this to still be more subtle because it's in the distance. So, the fog is back there. So let's get going. So you can see my watercolor pencil marks are just blending, melting right back in. Now... This still, well, it should be okay, but if I feel like it's still a little too blue, I'm still just adding a little bit of white.
And how high up do we go with
that? We're going to add, you're going to definitely have to add more white. Just go right on the canvas.
Oh, right on the canvas.
And that way, we want this to be as light as possible. Okay, now you can see, Alan, what I'm doing here.
Yeah.
I'm cleaning off my brush, and I'm flipping it back and forth. And
I'm doing the same thing.
Yes. So let that transition up. But I feel like as that's drying, do some bigger brush strokes. You're going to need some more white down in there.
Okay.
And then we're just going to transition into, you can see I just put some little dots on there.
Yeah.
Take that extra off on my paper towel. And I'm just going to blend. But you see how strong this blue is?
Yeah.
Now, because it's stronger, I'll push it off to the side. And then as I need more paint, I won't grab any more blue.
So
I'm just grabbing
with
the white
blue spots.
But keep them off just a tiny bit of blue because it's really strong. Remember,
you know I'm heavy-handed.
We want to keep this really light. And you can see how I'm doing more of a cross hatch technique. We can also blend it, but the pattern doesn't matter too much because we're covering it up with trees. And we don't want this to be real heavy and thick. A thick layer either because we need this to dry. So anytime you have too much, you just wipe it off on the paper towel. So you could see it's a fairly light blue, but
I think
it's
darker. I should add white.
Definitely lots of white. And then because it's going to dry darker.
You're right how dark it gets.
Yeah, it dries darker.
This is amazing, folks.
Okay.
Listen to Maria.
So you can see I like the way this looks, and again, the direction of the brush strokes, it really doesn't matter because the
I was trying
trees
to
are,
go up and down.
No, it doesn't matter because the trees, these little trees are going in on top of it.
Okay.
You just want to just get this on the canvas and get it before it dries, but it needs to be darker on the edges, Alan.
Okay.
So you can see here, I feel like mine still needs, And if it's still wet there, it will just keep blending in.
Right.
Acrylics dry really quickly, which is why you have to work fast. So.
Well, you're so good at
this. Being someone that is mostly impatient with things and I do everything fast, it works out really well for me.
Well, I'll try to follow your lead.
I don't usually paint with oils. They dry too slow for me. So you can see how mine's darker on the edges and then it's a little lighter all the way up through there.
Yeah,
so,
and
you need more paint. Like, don't be afraid to really load. I would go right into the white. You can mix it right on the canvas.
Okay.
And then just add your little bit of blue. And
just a touch.
And by going in different directions like this,
yeah,
that helps move the paint around.
Oh, yeah, it helps tremendously.
You just flip your brush around.
Yeah.
And then, yeah, there you go. All right.
And just go all the way
across? All the way. Just keep going, but keep that lighter in the center.
I'm trying to get
that. And if I feel, I think I'm going to rinse my brush. And I'm going to add just a tiny bit more white. I just really want this really bright, like that. It could be I'm thinking a morning.
We don't know which way the sun's shining here.
Yeah, well, it's coming up, so it's brighter at the horizon.
Okay, so it's a low horizon shot.
Yes, I would say maybe like 7:30, 8 o'clock in the morning.
Whoa.
That's what I think, in the fall. Yep. Yeah, so when you get... When you get here, let me grab your canvas for a second.
Go ahead.
Can you grab it for me? When you're blending and this looks really like dry like this, there's not enough paint on there. You need to keep it moving.
Well, I didn't get paint
there. Right, so that's more of a dry brush technique, which is really good for doing different textures. So that's just another technique.
What do I do next?
Just keep it moving, just keep that paint moving. You need more paint.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You can add a little bit of water. If you add too much water when you're painting with acrylics, it will like wick up the paint and pull everything back to the bare canvas, and it could be kind of a mess. So
we'll try not to.
Yeah, so we'll get this done, and then we are going to move on to the hillsides. So, yep.
All right, just I need more. A little.
And then, yep, so put that blue at the edges here because it's dark, and then just get white and mix it right on the canvas. More white, more. Okay, now just blend that all around. There you go. Good. That's it. Okay. All right, so then I'm going to, I'm going to use a smaller brush. So I'm going to rinse this brush. Always rinse your brushes or leave them in the water.
I better rinse mine.
When you're done, because the acrylics dry really quickly and your brushes will, the paint will dry in there. And if they do dry and you happen to forget about your brushes like I often do, you can use rubbing alcohol. Or hand sanitizer, which everybody has.
Whoa,
and you soak the brush in there and it will reactivate the acrylic paints.
I just bought a new bottle, a large bottle of hand sanitizer.
So,
I got plenty.
Yeah. So, and then always shape the brush. I could always shape it so those bristles stay nice and smooth.
You taught me that with that edge.
Yes. All right. So let's go to our...
Can we put that down?
Yes. 1/2 inch flat shader. So basically same brush, but smaller.
Mm-hmm. All right.
We're going to wet that. To bring the bristles together, I always shape them.
I'll do my shaping here.
Yes. Okay, so we are going to work on the hillsides. So you can do this a couple different ways. You can paint the solid color, lay on different colors as they dry. I like when the colors blend together. So we're going to work wet on wet. So we're mixing the colors right on the canvas, and we're not even waiting for the one to dry.
You're taking me to the next step.
But look, you already have your background. It looks great. Okay, so what we're going to do is we are going to start with the lighter colors and then get a little darker. We won't even have to clean the brush in between. So if a lot of times I'll do this when I'm on a big job and I only have a certain amount of time to get a mural done or something where...
She's the best at murals.
Well,
I
not
love
the best,
them.
But I'm still learning, but thanks. I always start
Picasso said that.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're still learning.
There's
at 90-some years old.
There's one thing I can say with 100% certainty that I've done that Picasso definitely was not able to do.
Whoa, what is that?
I was up on a 16-foot ladder painting clouds on a ceiling, and someone called me on my cell phone, and I was talking on the phone. while I was painting on the ceiling. Wow. I don't think he was
able
to do
that. Even Michelangelo didn't get to do that at the Sistine Chapel. He laid down.
Right. And then someone else is texting me, and I did text him back. I'm like, 16 feet in the air, up on a ladder. Please call me back later, you know.
You got skills.
Yeah, so that was interesting. But I turn it off now when I'm on the ladder.
Thanks for sharing that. So don't be on your cell phone.
No.
Follow the pickle.
That's right. So what I usually do is I think ahead. I'm like, what colors or the lightest, then I can go from like yellow to green to blue, and all of those colors will just mix into each other. I don't even have to clean my brush.
Wow.
So that's how we're going to do this. So we are going to start with these lighter colors first. So we don't have green in our palette.
I know.
But how are we going to make green?
Yellow and blue.
That's right. And we want it a little lighter, so we'll add one other color.
White.
Yeah. See, you're a pro. You're a pro. All right.
I'm keeping it simple in my answers.
Yeah. So we're going to mix. We'll first mix our color that we want. We want a color that's similar to the darker area in the sky, but not quite as dark as the true color that we have.
I'll put it on my plate.
Yeah. So let's take that blue, and we're going to add a little bit of yellow. So I'm going into, when I dip into my paints, I'm going into the little edge of my little paint pot so I don't contaminate the whole thing. You go right down in the middle.
Thank you for that tip.
Just kind of on the edge, yeah. So what I'm doing, you can see there's already, that's green. So I want it a little bit lighter, but I still want some of that blue in there. So I'm just going to take some white. So when I add the new colors to my palette, I keep them off to the side so that I can pull more in as I'm mixing.
Great tips.
So I like this. So we have three colors on my brush, and they're not, don't worry about mixing one solid color. You could see they're not mixed all together.
I see.
So I'm going like this and picking up all of these colors at the same time.
Wow.
See that?
Wow. This is amazing.
Yeah, like stop mixing and just like pick. See how you're mixing one color?
Yeah.
Put some a little bit more white next to it. Grab some more white and stick that next to your green. And then a tiny bit of blue. And put it don't mix it in, just put it beside it. Okay, put it beside. Okay. Now take that extra paint off your brush on your paper towel. Now take your brush and go like this in all of those colors you just mixed. The white, the blue, and the green. Okay, now don't mix. Oh. Okay, done. Good. Done. Okay. Okay.
Now let's go. Heavy-handed.
So look. So as we do this, all of the colors will come out off the brush at the same time. We're going to add more colors on here. So what you just come across like that. Now you can see I'm holding my brush in a horizontal fashion, and you can see how this you want to keep them separate, and that gives a little more interest in some of that brush stroke. You see that?
I see
it's
it.
Not
it made
one
a difference.
Solid green.
I did it that way. Now I'm doing it your way.
Grab,
and it's easier.
Right. Grab some more white and blue, put them on your plate beside them, and then dip into, so like here's some white.
Yeah.
Here's some blue, and now I already have my green. So now I'm going to take some green, white, and blue. And as we come down, so if you look at the picture, as we come down, we can get a little bit darker. And then I'm going to hit a little bit of yellow, just the yellow itself, right up in here, because that's more like the sunlight, the light hitting. And you can see I'm leaving some of this brush, a light hand. So I'm not smoothing the paint out, Alan. I'm just...
Oh, okay.
You see how I'm just...
You're just going like one across or...
Yeah,
just...
so kind of a... Just leaving some of those colors as they are without mixing everything. And then as we come down, I'm going to mix in more blue. Okay. And just let them blend together. You can see I'm just mostly horizontal brush strokes. But this is a hill. Okay,
yeah.
So you can see now my brush strokes, I'm starting to come up like this.
Yeah.
And then we'll come, I'm just going to come down. No, I don't like that. This looks a little too dark in here. So I'll just go back in with my other colors and just like that. So it's kind of a quick method of painting this. It's really looser, the looser it is, the nicer it will appear. This is not, we're not trying to do fine art here. We're doing the fun stuff, right?
Where yes,
it's more,
this is fun.
Impressionistic, I guess you could say.
Whoa.
So then as it comes
are
down
we getting
here.
Dolly-like or what?
Now I have sort of I have a warmer, it's not a true black. Uh-oh. It's almost like a dark wine color. So we are going to mix red. We're going to grab some red in here. And you can see with a little bit of that blue and that red mixing, you kind of want a dirty, dirty purpley color. So I am going to add a touch of black. We want this really dark. Now it's too black, so I'm going to add a little bit more red. So as I'm mixing those colors, and they're not what I want, I just move further on the palette so that I don't just keep mixing. My plates are squeaky. I don't keep mixing that same color that I don't want. So you could see that's the blue and red, a little bit of black.
Wow, and now I can't wait to get there. I'm still trying to do that.
Yeah, so this is a little bit more in shadow, which is why they're darker. You can see here. And then we're going to come in here, same thing, and we're just going to paint across here. Now I'm taking the black and I'm introducing some black. And again, I'm keeping the brush strokes just loose as if
like using the side of the brush there.
Yeah, just turning the brush. And so pretty much already putting our shadow in for our tree. So I'm coming all the way down with this black, but while it's wet, this is important, while it's wet, I'm going back to that red, purple, blue mix, and I'll put some of that in there. I switched to the foam plate because they don't absorb the water when you mix the
paint. Yeah, no, I noticed that.
They keep squeaking. You hear that squeaking?
Yes.
Maybe if I have two so it doesn't collapse on me. I'll just use the one. Okay. All right, so we have this. Now you can see of all these colors are mixing in, and we can go back in now, and I'm going to grab some red, and I'm going to, so when we do this, now you want to get darker now. You want to mix your red, blue, and a little bit of black.
I had to catch up a little
bit. No, it looks good.
So yeah, you can see. And then I shortened the path.
That's okay. We'll go back in.
No. Okay, I can correct that.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. It's just
all right, red, and
red, blue,
how much red?
Just equal parts probably.
And do it to the side.
Yep. Red, blue, and a little bit of black. Just a tiny bit of black.
Okay.
Yeah. And now I'm adding in my little, I'm going to clean my brush. And I want this, the edge of the brush, this in a vertical, not vertical, horizontal.
Yes. We're vertical today.
Yeah, horizontal. I'm holding it horizontally. And you can see I'm skipping. And
you just, see how black is that?
A little darker.
A little more black.
Yeah. Yeah.
I don't want to go too much.
No, you need to see how dark that is in there.
Oh, I got to go
darker. You need more black and more red. Because you want it almost like a wine color.
Okay. Yeah, yeah, so, I needed your help and assistance.
Yeah, no, it's good.
Thank you.
So I'm skipping. I'm picking the brush up and just hitting, laying it down here and there. And this is maybe the illusion of fallen leaves, the light reflecting from the trees. We're not painting every single leaf. We're just painting little paint daubs that indicate where we feel there could be, you know, some leaves. So we'll do that pathway later, but you can see there.
Well, I'll need help on that.
Yeah,
sure.
And we could see where it's just bringing some of those colors. Our eyes, the cones in our eyes see the red, I think, first. Red.
Yeah, like a stoplight.
Yellow. Like the gold and yellow color. That's why, do you ever notice when in hockey?
Yes.
The ring around the hockey rink, it's yellow.
Yes.
So they can pick that up out of their, you know, on the sides of their peripheral vision or however
right.
you say that.
Right. Just like in baseball, they like the green backgrounds.
Right. So I've heard, and I don't know how often they do this, but I've heard hockey players, opponents, will put yellow laces in their skates.
Sure.
So that when the other guys are looking for the puck, their eye will go to their skate.
Oh,
instead
wow.
of the. So I don't know how true that is, but I've read that.
I believe in sports, if they're not looking for an edge to beat
you,
they're not trying.
So but that's
makes sense. Thanks for telling a sports guy that.
Well, and that's how powerful the colors are with our eyes. So that's where, when you use red in a painting, you are adding that red because you want the viewer's eye to go to that area.
I'm adding red then.
Yes. Now we want to do some little skips. See, so it's like little sections, maybe little piles of leaves. And the tree has the reds and the oranges. So we're repeating that at the bottom. If we just had that red at the bottom here it's okay, but our eye's just going to the bottom. And we really want this, our eye to move around the canvas. So I added the red, and now I'm, and I had red on my brush, so I can go right into the orange. And now I'm just going to, just here and there, you can see I'm just adding, not a ton of the orange, just here and there, and we can always add a little more as we need it. But you could see how pretty that is already, like that's the leaves. So that looks good. So I would say clean the, so anytime you want your, you want that nice chiseled edge on your brush, and once your brush starts getting loaded with paint, it starts to get all poofy.
Thank you, I did.
So you need to get that paint out of the brush. It goes up into the ferrule of your brush, which is never supposed to go up in there. Mine does all the time, but you know.
I know, I was knocking on
the
door.
I'm a messy painter. So you every once in a while you clean the brush and just get that extra paint out of there. So you see that nice chiseled edge here?
Did you add orange?
I did. So now if you want to go in that,
I want to do some orange too.
Yeah, so just grab some orange. And I'm holding this.
And put it on the side and then grab or just paint just, directly?
I'm going right on the canvas. But do you want that nice chiseled edge and hold that brush horizontally?
Thank you for the guidance.
And just do some little dashes. And that's it. So we already have, And you can do them in the, like little sections. Like there might be more in one section than another, like a little pile of leaves. So you know, there might be more leaves here than there. So you don't want them to be too uniform looking. You want to kind of mix it up a little bit.
Thank you.
So that's pretty much it for that. All right. So now we are going to, let's see. I want this to dry down in here. So we're going to work on the leaves in the background. I think you're probably pretty good.
I can move on?
Yeah.
All right.
The only thing I would say is maybe where these colors meet, like they should transition, they should blend.
Like a little lighter.
No, like just take this color, take these colors and just meet
okay,
this.
Okay, so I gotta go back.
Just whatever's on your brush right now, just put it on there, cover up some of that blue color, yeah. Yeah,
that's okay. All.
You just
I was hesitant for
see
that.
See, you want to go from one color to the other, You want them to transition.
Thank you for
there,
your help.
That looks better, yeah. So the color that's up here should not be down there.
It should
be, yeah.
Well, I'll cover
and then
it
we
up.
Can, that looks better. And then
thank
just
you.
Where these meet, instead of having that harsh line.
Yeah.
It, see how of, some of mine are.
Oh, it's like faded. Like.
You want to cross-pollinate the colors.
Okay.
So you want some of, yeah. So just with the dirty brush, just throw some. Yeah, don't make a line. Oh. Just.
It's drying out.
That's good.
You said these acrylics dry.
Yeah. That's good.
I'll work
you see
hard.
How it just is a smoother transition instead of a harsh line. And then the same thing where this, you want to just get rid of that harsh line. Just put a little bit more of this color.
I'll see if it's.
Yeah. And then just where that harsh line is, just put a little bit into. But again, don't make another line. Just put some dashes and just let it skip. Now introduce, put a couple here, a couple there. Like just introduce that, put a couple here.
Oh, with the orange?
Just keep, see there's little skips of paint in between? Don't put a line, just put little bits of it, so little bits of each color, and then put a little space in between.
Okay.
It just transitions from one color to the other better.
I'm trying to learn.
Okay. All right, that looks good, and we can always follow up on that as we go. All right, so clean that brush. Now we're going to paint all these trees in the background, right?
Oh my goodness.
Now, we're doing this all freehand.
Oh my goodness.
If you listen to what I say, you'll be good.
I'm listening.
All right, is he gonna listen?
I hear you loud and clear.
I think, we'll see.
That's why I was nervous going in.
We're good, you'll be fine.
I will try to do my best.
You'll be fine. All right, so we are going to use a little round liner brush. Some of them are shorter than others.
Yes. Is it this one?
No, a little round. It has a little, like a little pointy one.
The pointy one.
Yes.
Yeah, you need to say pointy.
Pointy.
I'm
well,
real
it's
literal.
Round. Yes.
Well, so, they're all round and little.
Okay. Wet the brush. This one had some of the glue in there. Always wet the brush and always keep that little point.
Look what I'm doing. You taught me.
Yep. I know. You're good. You're a pro. So what we want
not
to...
Not yet.
Well, so you may have mixed your colors slightly lighter or darker than mine, right?
Yes, I did.
So whatever color you have on your darkest area, the darkest blue, you want to go one or two shades darker than that. So we need it to be, actually we don't, we need to mix a color first. So let's grab, I take that back. Let's grab just whatever brush we already had.
Okay.
Your half inch, probably the half inch shader.
Yeah, I'll get the half inch.
So let's mix a color.
I'll put the pointy one to the side.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So we're gonna grab our white, always start with a lighter color.
Yeah.
And then the blue, because we're mixing that background color, but now we wanna make sure, and it dries darker.
Yeah.
So we wanna make sure it's darker than this one.
Then we get some blue.
Blue, and then what we're going to do is add a tiny, tiny, tiny bit of black.
Black?
Not too much.
You're trusting me on this.
So we want, that was too much on mine too. So, okay. And you can see I'm dripping on my canvas, but that's okay.
Oh my good, whoa.
Now remember, this is going to dry a little darker. So
it dried way too dark.
Whoa, okay, just go to another section. I would say clean the brush off.
Okay.
And
yeah.
Then that's okay. Leave that there, and I'll just grab the white and the blue.
Okay.
And pull some of that into it.
I thought you were going to
guide
me on that.
There's no mistakes. No mistakes.
Yeah. Thank you.
You just.
We can overcome it with paint.
Yes. So you mix the blue and the white, and then I'm pulling
I'll put
in
the white and then the blue.
Yeah. Don't put it on top of it. Go to another section and then pull in the black that you need. So you need blue.
All right. I'll go blue. And I'll put it in a separate section.
So that way, that's why these plates, they get so filled up so quickly. You just, if you go next to the color you're trying to mix, you just pull in some
this
of those other colors. Okay, I still think it's too black.
Okay, more
in my
white.
Opinion. Blue.
Blue?
Blue. But go next to it. Don't go on that same spot. Go beside it.
Where do you mean?
Anywhere beside it, because you're going back into the same color and it's still staying the same.
I got you. So
you know what I'm saying? If you start a new area,
it
will give you
help.
A cleaner color.
Yeah.
I would, okay, maybe just that's probably good. That's probably good.
All right.
All right, so now we have our color.
Yeah.
So put that brush in the water.
All right.
And now we're gonna grab our small one. Now we want to add a little bit of water to this to make sure that it will flow. You can see I'm grabbing some water and I'm putting the water
right on what I just did.
Yes, and this is why the foam plates are better for this application.
I'm sold on these plates.
Well,
this is great.
If they're the paper plate, they still work, but they do tend to absorb a little bit more of the water. So we want this to be more of a inky consistency.
Yeah,
so
it is.
I think you need more water.
A little more?
Yes. And then go like this. When you're mixing the paint, you can see I'm pulling it in. See how I'm twirling the brush? Like this, long ways.
Okay.
We want to keep that point, and this is why we need that point. All right, now this is where, ready?
I'm ready.
Ready, listen?
Yes.
Okay, so we are painting right now all of these little trees. So we're going to start with the trunks, and all they are is lines. They're just lines, ready? And we're going to start here at the top of the hill, and we're going to come up. That's it, and just paint some lines. And I think I still want some little bit more blue in mine. So, you know, some of them could be bluer, some could be grayer. Now, I feel like they're kind of a little chubby. I want some of them thinner. I just add a little bit more water and take some of that paint off and like kind of squeeze that paint out of my brush and just come in and lift it up so that you want them to have the little tails at the top. Go like this. You lift your hand up.
Yeah, you taught me those tails. I'm trying
to. That looks good.
Yeah.
And then as now when we come into, they look really good, Alan. When we come into this area where it's whiter in the center, we again want to make sure they're darker than that center area, but not as dark as the other ones because they'd have the light hitting them. So these trees are going to be a little lighter. See how they're a little lighter than the Okay. And then I'm going to even put in maybe just some little dabs of paint as if there were maybe some little shrubs in there too. You see how the trees are kind of sitting in some shrubbery. I'm just grabbing some little dabs of paint here. And then I'll do that. I think the trees, I like that. They need to be kind of in some shrubs, maybe some of the types of shrubs like cardinals like to hang out in.
Yeah, I like seeing the cardinals.
Yeah.
And most of them do stay year-round.
Yeah, they do.
Especially those beautiful males.
Oh, yeah. We feed them. Every once in a while when they're molting, like this time of year, sometimes even October, they molt and they have all these feathers off their head and they're like mostly bald. I'm like, I feel like I want to bring them in and knit them a little cap or something. They're going to get cold. But
get a little cap
for
that.
My bird expert friends say, no, they come back, and they usually do. But I just think it's kind of funny. They look cold to me.
I know.
So you can see, you can put as many or little, amount of trees. Could probably put some crooked ones. They're not all perfectly straight.
Right.
I like yours. Yours are nice and big.
Yeah, trying to give the little flare out there.
Yeah. Now, when we do the leaves, we want to, we're going to come in same colors. I might need to add, I might need to add some more trunks in a different, once we get this up, get this going, I feel like I need a couple darker ones just to stand out here and there. Okay, so I have a lot of my little trees in here.
Yeah.
And then we're going to take the half inch shader. We'll use that again. Now we're using the same color. So on the darker trees, use that same mix. On the lighter trees, use a lighter. And we're just coming in. We're not painting every leaf.
Okay.
They're just blobs.
You now need
blobs
help
of
on
color,
this.
But you can see. And you don't want one big blob. You want that variation of the different colors. So we're just going like this. You can see I'm moving that. I'm leaving. See the gaps in between.
Yeah.
I'm not making a big ball like a lollipop tree. I'm just doing this. I'm cleaning my brush off.
Right. So I go back to the half inch.
Yes, and you can see
I got to put a couple shrubs.
This is the canopy of the trees, but we don't really want we just want it to be very loose. And then as it comes in to this area, it's going to be lighter again. So we want the canopy of the trees to be lighter. A little bit more blue on there. This is a little tricky because they do dry a little darker. And then we can add some other little branches here and there if you want to. But you can see there's some light and dark. It's too light in there.
Where do I pull the darker?
Because
mine's
for the canopy.
Leaves. The canopy.
Use your same colors.
Okay.
Same colors, but you still need a couple. If you want to put a couple little trees in the center, but keep them lighter. See how they're lighter?
Oh yeah.
So use the same color, but just add white.
Okay.
Just add white.
That's where I needed help.
Yep. Anytime.
I didn't want to mess this up with too heavy a hand.
I mean, generally you add white when you want something to be lighter, but not always if you're...
That's why I consulted with you first. I'm trying to listen.
No, you're doing good. Usually you would use white. If you're mixing, you're using red and you want a lighter red, if you add white, it makes pink. If you add orange or yellow, it will give you a nicer, lighter red. So let's see, we have our dark, just like I said, very loose, go all the way off to the edges of the canvas, very loose.
I see.
So that kind of resembles some trees. All right. Yours look really good, Alan.
I'm getting there.
No, I kept mine looser. Alan's.
Yeah.
They look great. He has less trees and they're bigger and they're more distinct, which I like that too.
A little different.
No, it's good.
Thank you.
You don't have to make it look like mine. Yours is is make it your own.
It's truly my own.
That's right, as it should be. We all have different hands, and as we paint, we see things
and different
differently.
Eyes too.
Yeah, so it should be different. Could you imagine how boring it would be if everybody painted the same way?
Yes.
And did everything the same? Right? That's what makes... That's how you contribute to the world, is by being different. Being yourself.
I tried my best.
Yeah. So you can see I'm just grabbing... I'm just putting in some extra little trees. Now keep in mind, this larger tree is going to cover some of these, so don't worry too much about... This section here, some of those will get covered.
Right.
So I'm just laying
all in. Right, with my canopy, I need that help with
what? So the half inch brush.
Okay, let me rinse this out.
And then do the same. You're going
the same color that
same color. Now the trick here is to not make a big blob, just move that brush around. So when you have this color, the color on your brush,
yeah,
I'm going like this, then I'm gonna move to a different spot.
You're sort of like dabbing it in.
Dabbing it, and you can see I'm flipping my brush, and I'm also moving, I'm moving it around, so I'm doing this. See?
Oh, okay.
Kind of like this. This is basically what you're doing. And then you do that with the darker color.
So it doesn't look like a big blob.
Yeah, and just move it around. So you want some of that sky to show through. Okay? Yeah, and just move it around and flip your brush too so that you don't have all the same brush stroke.
Yeah.
Turn your brush. See, if you turn your brush this way and then this way, it gives you the different shape.
Oh, okay.
You don't want them all to be the same direction. You need a different direction because the light would be hitting.
So like left and right.
Yes, you just flip, and that's pretty much it. So we have our little trees, our little forest of trees here. That looks good. And I would say you can even push a little bit harder and get some.
I was trying to be light.
Because we just want to fill it in.
Oh, okay.
But yeah, do big ones, small ones, but just different.
All right. You know, I need your help.
Yeah.
Thank you.
So that's it. So that's what we have there. And I'm going to move along. Okay.
I'll check. Yeah, go back ahead. You can leave me in the dust.
Okay. So what we want to do is just come in. I'm just going to grab a little bit of the white and the yellow, the colors I have at the very edge, and I'm just going to clean up this little edge here where those, just like that. Okay, and now the pathway.
I'm using the same brush. I'll need help on that.
Yeah, you will.
I got to extend mine back
up.
You're
good. So this one, so if you did go up a little, and mine did too. You can see I covered up. I'm just going up here with the white.
Yeah, I went too far. I cut it down.
Good.
I got carried away with carrying it over to
That's
the far
okay.
right.
And then, so we're going from yellow. We're doing the same way as we did the hill, wet on wet. So we're going from white to yellow to more of like a golden color. So I'm adding a little bit of orange and let that mix in. Really warm, pretty colors here. And then the red.
Nice.
And then we have a lot of red down at the bottom here. And you can see I'm just skipping with the brush, just letting it fill in. And even the pathway, you can kind of do something like that. I'm going to bring in some of these colors. There's a little bit of some shadow here. Just letting them all mix.
I'm already surprised at what you taught me to do here, teacher.
And would there be blue? You know, again, this is art. We're just having fun with this. We're mixing in these colors.
That pathway looks unbelievable.
Jono's over there. 40 minutes, 40 minutes. Okay.
No way.
We're good, Jono. All right.
He's the best stage boy.
Yeah. So there's our pathway. We can always touch it up as we need to. Now the tree comes on top. So I'm mixing black. And a little bit of, say, orange in there, really any color, but I'm gonna grab orange. I just want it to be a softer black, not such a harsh black. And the tree, we're gonna decide the tree's sitting right here. We're gonna take our brush, and we're just gonna pull it up wherever we want that tree to be in our canvas. And we're gonna curve it a little bit this way. We'll come up this way.
Oh, I can't wait for that.
Yeah.
I gotta get my white path all the way up there, though. So.
Yeah, just add some white.
Can I just add it to the brush right now and do it? Or?
Sure.
All right.
Sure. So my tree's a little curved here. I'll bring branch up. And I'm going all the way off the edge of the canvas because we want this to look like it's bigger than, you know, if we can't see the top of the tree, that these are going off.
Oh, wow.
The canvas. Now, to make the smaller branches, you can go back to the little round brush, and you can come in and just add. But we're going to add the smaller ones after we do some of these leaves. And I'm grabbing, while I have my small brush.
Well, I got my path all the way up there, so.
I'm gonna grab a little bit of yellow, and I'm just brushing it on the trunk.
Should I just go yellow next and then put yellow in?
Yes, just the transition.
You told me we can dirty the brushes, so.
Yeah. Go from yellow, white to yellow, to orange and red.
Uh-oh,
fire trucks. All right, and you can see I'm just grabbing some little bit of the black, like little shadow here. Throw a little bit of black over here. Okay, and then it would be the darkest over here because that's more in shadow.
And you said red next I can do?
Yes, or? So you could see the orange.
Okay, mm-hmm. I was trying to follow yours because it looks so brilliant.
Yeah, white, yellow, orange, red.
Okay, then mm-hmm. I'll put orange.
And now we're going to do the leaves on the tree, which we're still doing the same way as the trees in the background, but we're using the bright colors. So we are going to mix some of the dark. Like you could see on here, we have some dark colors. We have a dark red, a brighter red, orange, yellow. We're just mixing everything in there, even a little bit of green. So I'm going to start with the darker, and I'm not doing too many of these. This is like the dirty, warm black. I'm just doing just here and there, okay? This will add just a little bit of depth. I don't want too many of these, but just want to break it up. And you want to cover up some of the branches also. I'm going way over here. All right, then I'm going into my red. And I'm just doing some of them. I'm pulling in some of that black and a little bit of blue too, just so it's a little bit darker.
I can't wait to get to that.
No, I kind of feel like some of these are going to be too big. I'm gonna grab, there's a little quarter inch flat shader. Yeah, that's better. I'm just kind of, and you just wanna move around at random. Just move them around. You can see, throw the leaves in. And you can put the leaves in places where you don't have a little branch yet because I'll add that branch with my little liner.
Wow.
Okay. We're gonna do that. And then I'll add some orange. We're just using the different colors here. And you can see I'm going different directions. And I'm going over top of some of the other leaves that I already did. So this, you know, you want this to fill in. You want to see the sky in between. But I'm going to let this dry a little and I can come back to it and show it done. I want to do our little people because I need this to dry or else the leaves are just going to blend too much with each other, and I need them to just kind of stand out on their own, some of these colors. So I'm gonna let this dry a little and go to my people.
On your path, I saw you put a little blue, so I should grab blue and just try to do that and be creative.
Yeah, you can, you don't have to. I'm adding just a little bit.
No, I just like that.
Sure.
Blue's one of my favorite colors.
Is it? Yeah. I put some blue on my brush right now, and it's mixing in and making little bits of green. All right, so that's our tree. Again, I'll add our little branches, but I'm gonna do my little people. Now the people are just like little.
Yeah.
Your little people right in here, and then we'll look at our highlights and shadows that we need. And I still have to let those leaves dry first. So I'm taking the black, and we're just painting two little dots like this, and then a little squiggle, like a little carrot.
Whoa,
see?
The squiggle.
Like a little carrot, right?
Yeah.
And then, maybe they could be holding hands. So we can do something like that and then bring out maybe like these two little legs or something. So that's all. That's all the people are. So we're gonna put their heads up above that vanishing point here. So we're gonna put one there, one there. We're gonna do a little squiggle for their body. Okay. Well, that looks like she turned sideways. And then some little arms, maybe they're holding hands. Okay.
Looks like that is beautiful.
Something. Oops, I got a little bit wide there. And then maybe a little bit, like there's another little leg. I think she's holding something because my brush, it like moved on me. So like she's holding a puppy or something. I don't know what she's holding.
And then it might be a doll.
Yeah, I'm taking that extra paint off on the paper towel. I'm not wetting it, and I'm just doing
Should I use
little.
The half? I heard you say, but half brush for the tree?
Yes.
And it'll be black?
A warm black. Add a little bit of the orange to it.
Oh, orange to it,
just
okay.
To warm it up. And now this, just a little bit of the black, almost like a gray.
I've got to find a spot to put this in here.
I don't like that. There's a little bit right here. That was too big there. Okay. So there are people. We can add their little details now. We can add some little highlights on our grass. We can add little highlights just here and there. And that's what we'll, I'm going to go back in and look at everything now.
Since I'm listening, here's my black.
Yes.
Need you to,
that looks good.
I'm good to go.
And
with
you want
that.
A generous amount of black on your brush so that when you do the brush stroke for the tree trunk, it doesn't skip too much and it'll fill it in.
Okay.
So you could see, I feel like it needs a little bit of shadow, a little bit of dark down in here. And that's pretty much it. I'm gonna let it dry. I'm gonna let this dry so that the leaves, that right now they're still a little wet and they need to, I need to put the brighter colors on top. So I need to let this dry and then we'll get Alan to finish up, right? And
yeah.
We'll show them done, so. So we're finished with our paintings. Let's see how Alan did. Now remember, he never painted, he didn't draw.
I was
he
like
did this all freehand too, so I think it's fantastic.
Look how steady I am.
You did good. So let's turn.
Let's see.
Let's turn it around. Oh, I love it. I love your style. You do have a style. You do.
It's unique.
Yeah, maybe when we're done, we'll bring in all of our paintings together and like line them up or something and see, like maybe get a shot of everything you did throughout the year and
December, my bedroom wall, I'm going to hang them in my bedroom wall, all 12 of them.
Nice. Yeah.
Thank you so much.
They look good together. But that's the thing. Everybody has their own style, right? They should not look the same. Mine doesn't even look the same as the other one that I did. So.
And if you want to do this, Maria, tell them how to see the short video.
Well, on BPTV.
Yeah.
Okay. And then the BPTV YouTube channel is, what is that?
BPTV.
Is it
BPTV?
Okay. Yeah. BPTV. Okay. And then Maria's Ideas Art also, but it's on
YouTube.
Yeah, on YouTube.
Yeah. But, I don't mind spreading the wealth.
Yeah.
We're co-producing, co-hosting, and we're co-painting.
Yes, we are co-painting. And there's a little video for each episode so that you can draw it on your own. So that's all.
Hold it. Tell them about the
Nature
kits.
Walk. Oh, wait. In the next month.
Yeah.
Next month. The kits?
Yeah.
Oh, the kits.
Yeah.
So next month we are going to paint this. It's pumpkin time.
Yes.
And we're going to have a special guest for that one too.
I can't wait. Yeah. We're going to tease you. Wait till you hear and see who this next guest is.
Yes. No swearing on that show.
We won't tell why. It'll be another good one, and her guests and her themes. I salute you.
Thanks.
9 months in, and I'm trying to be an artist.
You are an artist.
I didn't get any paint
on
me.
Did you paint?
Yes.
Then you're an artist.
I salute you. Thank you so much.
You're already an artist. Everybody is. Everyone.
Stay tuned to the first Friday of each month. Yes. We're at Jono's studio here. You can't miss it. It's all decorated. It shines. When I mention that studio in Mount Oliver, they go, I've seen it for years. I go, I'm painting with them.
Yeah.
So
we're on
check
the slopes,
it out.
On the hilltop. Southside slopes.
There you go. Simple as that.
Yeah.
See you next month. Thanks for all the feedback and compliments, and we appreciate you. And get your paintbrush out.
Yeah, follow the pickle. Okay, thanks.